Hi, dear road friends. So this week we have Earth Day. Today's actually Earth Day. So we're going to be having some fun outside, getting our hands dirty, and learning how to compost. But first we should probably talk about why you should go through all the effort to compost. So Earth Day is a time where you should think about how you can be nicer to the Earth, do things that help her. Think of her like a friend, and we always want to be nice and helpful for our friends. So composting helps the Earth because it helps save water when you use the dirt to plant vegetables or flowers, because it holds the water better, so you don't have as much water runoff and waste. And when you throw away things like orange peels and bananas and apples, and they go to landfills, there's not enough air, so it helps the fruit turn into methane gas, which is not the best. So when you compost, it helps the fruits and kitchen waste to aerate, and it doesn't make that nasty gas. So it's good for you, and it's good for the environment, and we are gonna get into it. I also forgot to mention that composting helps save space in landfills, which is good, because some things have to go in a landfill, but stuff like this can go in your backyard or inside. So now we can talk about options for your compost. I'm using this. This is really small. I wouldn't normally compost in this, but it's our only clear container. I want you guys to be able to see all the layers. But you can have it actually just in a pile in your backyard. You can put it in a trash can. You can put it in a flower pot. You can really compost in just about anything. It just depends on how big of a pile you want and what works for where you live. So we're going to be using this today just as an example. So what you're going to want to start with is dirt if you're going in a container. If you're going just like on the ground in your backyard, you don't have to put dirt on the ground because it's already got dirt. So I'm going to put some dirt in my container. So you want to make sure you have a nice little layer on the bottom, because this is going to be the start of your compost, and this is going to be what the nutrients from all of our kitchen waste is going to start sinking into at first. So after your dirt, you're going to need some twigs and straw. So the trick to composting is all about balance. You need wet and you need dry. Maybe rain. Alright, so we have our dirt, and then we have some sticks and some straw. Kind of see. Straw will get squished down. Lawn clippings. So I just have grass, some leaves, and this is going to also help. The grass and the leaves are going to like fall apart and disintegrate and absorb into the dirt. And then we're going to put some of our kitchen waste in here. Now you can basically put any of your kitchen waste in a compost, just not meat. So you can do eggshells, banana peels are a really good thing to put in there. We have a lot of orange peels, so we're going to put in a bunch of our orange peels. If you have like a salad that's going bad, you can put your salad in there. We have all of our eggshells. Break those up a little bit more. And all of these things are just gonna, over the next 4 to 6 months, turn into basically dirt. And then we're just gonna keep alternating, so maybe put a little bit more dirt in there in the middle. Just keep going back and forth. And then as you get kitchen waste, you have your food that goes bad, instead of putting it in the garbage, you'll just go to your bucket or your pile in the backyard, and you'll throw your compost in there. And so this is a little example of what a compost would be. So we have our dirt, our twigs and our straw, some kitchen waste, some more dirt, some more yard waste, that grass and those leaves. And now we should probably talk about why you want to do this for you. This is the best fertilizer you're going to be able to get. There's not really any pesticides in it because you usually wash your fruit and vegetables before you eat them. And it's just going to take all of that goodness out of it and put it back into the dirt. It saves room in your regular trash can. It's going to help your plants grow. So if you already have a garden, this is going to be, like I said, better fertilizer. And yeah, it's just good. It returns all of the nutrients back into that soil so we can reuse, reduce, recycle in the spirit of Earth Day. So I hope you guys had fun watching, and I hope you guys try to compost if you can. If you do end up trying it, feel free to send in some pictures and videos so we can see how you guys did and what yours looks like. And yeah, have fun.